lessened to an extent that it was a tangible fallen light. Scripture says life is in the blood. That's accurate. But when you grow up, when you get to heaven, life isn't in the blood, other than the blood of Jesus that redeemed you. It's in the light that now flows through you. Both Adam and Eve had light flowing through them, and Jesus, when he rose from the dead, said, I'm flesh and bone. What was his life then? Light. Oh, come on, get this revelation. You already have this light in you. His light is your life. If you grasp this and grab hold of this, that light will eradicate every disease and infirmity known to man out of your body. Well, it's appointed unto man once to die. This is truth. Does not Scripture say you're dead and your life is now hidden in Christ? Oh, you haven't died that death yet? Paul said, I die daily. How? Well, you know, we've got to put off this mortal body. There is a generation that's going to get a revelation, and they're going to transition from this life to eternity without seeing death. In 2014, at this conference, when we came to do this, I was in the hotel praying and seeking the Lord for the message, and I had a visitation from Elijah. And I said, sir, what are you here for? He said, the Lord sent me to teach you how a man can go from the natural life to eternity without tasting death. I said, I'm listening. You know what he did? He said, do this. He put out his hand and it instantly became light. He said, practice. In essence, he was saying, get the revelation you are light. Practice allowing the light to have the preeminent position and the flesh to go back to the position it was created to do. Following, not leading. The natural realm is not the reality you were created for. It's the eternal realm. And if you learn to put it in proper perspective, you will be astonished. This is the hour we're in right now. This is what God's doing. And it belongs to us. Now, I want to, you know, when I started studying this 3 years ago, I had to study physics because God said, light be. Here's the first thing the Lord said to me. Pay attention. I am light. But when I created light, it's a lesser light. It's not the light of God, the creator. It's a created light. So when God said, light be, 186,200 miles per second came out of his mouth. That's the speed of light. You know, science, physics has discovered that the closer you get to the speed of light, the more time slows down. It slows down. As a matter of fact, by the time you get to the speed of light, time ceases. Why? Because if you get past the created light, if you get past that speed, you step into eternity. Some of you are going, what? Isaiah 40, verse 12. Scripture says, and I'll paraphrase it, that everything God created, including light, all the galaxies, all the stars, all of space, all of time, fits in the span of his hand. He's a big God. Amen. Psalm 8, he says, I give you dominion over all the works of my hand. All of space, all of time, all of the galaxy, everything. He's given us the... How is that possible? Well, Joshua modeled that. Sun, stand still. And it did for 24 hours. That's been proven scientifically, by the way. A good friend of our family back in the 70s was Dr. Chuck Campbelljohn, a physicist that worked for NASA. They did all the math to put a lunar lander on the moon, and they could not come up with the equations even to get the proper trajectories and to get the proper, it just wasn't working. And this man, who's a Christian, said, wait a minute, let's add this 24 hours. And he said, wait a minute, there's another one. The sundial went back 10 degrees, so we got to, and when they did that, it fit perfectly. Fact. The sun stood still for 24 hours. Fact. You have a greater covenant, a greater blessing. Fact, you have that authority. But also a fact, you must be led of the Spirit, not free.